So this workshop is about self-development, and through our self-development, we can be useful, we can be good teachers, we can help the others also to explore, to be in harmony. Okay. So this homework was given at the end of the 5-day workshop, and you must be recalling that the basic program of action to be happy in continuity is to understand the harmony and to live in harmony at all these levels. And 3 steps were outlined for that. 1 step is self-exploration, which we have just discussed. And explore the proposals, verify those proposals. And the outcome of verifying those proposals would be right understanding. That right understanding of harmony would lead to feeling and thought of harmony, which is naturally acceptable to you. And it would lead to an expression of it in terms of harmonious behavior and work and participation and all that. So this is one important step. The second one was to be aware of your imagination every moment, and then to evaluate that and see whether it matches with your natural acceptance or not. That also we have briefly touched on. The idea is that once we discover our natural acceptance, that can be the guide for our imagination. It can purify our imagination and all the accumulated imagination also. So that was discussed during the 5-day workshop. If anybody would like to comment on that, you are welcome. I'll lower all the hands so that we have focus on this particular question. Would anybody like to comment on this? Okay. I'll not spend a whole lot of time on this because we have to start, you know, looking into it in terms of practice. This was also discussed briefly, that the self-exploration, what it means. It means this process we had discussed. And we had also discussed about this purification. Purification of not only the imagination, but the accumulated imagination, accumulated over all time. So if you look at our sanskar, our accumulated acceptances derived out of all our desire, thought and expectation, all our imagination from all time. So we have some formula of life, tit for tat, or be respectful regardless, and things like that, you know, so many formulas are there. So those are part of our sanskar. So to purify our sanskar, this was also discussed, that we have a given sanskar at a time, at the present time. We have a certain environment at that time, and if we are doing some self-exploration during that time, then it leads to a new sanskar, a new set of acceptances. Isn't it? An environment which is for mutual development, it is conducive to mutual development, is very useful for developing our sanskars in the right direction. And of course, the self-exploration is the most important thing, whether this environment is very conducive or it is not conducive. If you are doing self-exploration, it will certainly improve the sanskar over a period of time. On the other hand, if we are always looking at the negative things and things like that, regardless of the environment, our sanskar will become worse and worse. isn't it? So let's see, there is one hand raised. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, on the left hand side, you have got a new sanskar. The T plus one means new sanskar, isn't it?
Yeah, new sanskar.
Yes, yes. Okay.
So every moment your sanskar is getting updated, it is becoming better or worse. It is not constant. It is always becoming better or worse. But if we have an environment which is conducive to our mutual development, it accepts you as you are now. You may be a good guy, you may be a horrible person, whatever it is. The environment or the family, the friends, they accept you as you are. They are able to digest your indefinite conduct. You may have, you know, a lot of reaction and all that. They say, okay, fine, you know, this guy is like this right now. But they help you to pay attention. They help you to develop your understanding. They help you to develop your feeling and so on. They don't keep criticizing you, complaining to you and things like that, right? So if you have such an environment, it is very helpful. If it is not there, still, you know, you can still do self-exploration. And if you are doing the self-exploration, even for some time, it will be very helpful for developing new sanskar, which is better than this sanskar at time t. Does that make sense?
Yes, 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 sir. Yes. Actually, this t plus one becomes a little bit confused because you can take t prime. Then because this t is a time, because sanskar at time t, environment at time t, and self-exploration at certain time t. Isn't it, sir?
Yeah, yeah. It is, you know, you have a timeline.
Yes.
Right? You have your timeline. So let us say this is t and this is t plus one.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, instead of drawing point, I'm trying, you know,
yes,
you know,
yes,
drawing something bigger. All right. So at this, during this time, you started with some sanskar, right? You had certain environment and you did some effort for yourself in terms of self-exploration. If you did that, then at the next moment, you have a new sanskar. So this is t plus one, and this is what you had to start with. Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, I understand.
Yeah. So for example, in this time, you may have done, let us say this time is 1 week. This time is 1 week. And during this time, you did, you know, let us say the FDP on UHV. You did some FDP. And something you were able to explore. So your new sanskar is better than your old sanskar. Because of the effort that you made, all this effort, the self-exploration, you are making this effort. Okay. We are providing this environment.
And a wrong step will also lead to a bad sanskar also.
of course.
Yes,
of course.
Yes, yes.
You can actually, you have been teaching for how long?
I have been teaching for the last 35 years.
Okay, so let us take just last 10 years.
Mm.
Have the children who come to your class become more reactive or less reactive?
Less reactive. Yes.
They have become better.
Yes, they have become better.
Okay, very nice. So they have worked on their self-exploration and so on, right? In the society overall, has the society become more violent or less violent?
Society, in the last 10 years you are talking, sir?
Yeah, last 10 years.
I think...
Take some time frame.
So,
previous image and new image.
Mm.
So you can find out, you know, what the state of affairs is. But for yourself, focus on yourself. And out of these three, can you do anything about your present sanskar?
Yes.
It is a given. You can't do anything about it. You can certainly look for some better environment. But this is your number one handle on improving your sanskar. Can you see that?
That is right, actually.
Yeah. If you are not doing the self-exploration, you are just dependent on your environment, for everybody else to be nice to you and so on. Will your new sanskar be better, or it will not change if you're not doing this? So if you're not doing your self-exploration, you're not looking into things, you're not trying to find, you know, what is naturally acceptable to you, etc., then your sanskar is not going to become better. It may become worse or stay the same, more or less, or may become marginally better. That is also possible. But if you are self-exploring and you are spending time on it and effort on it, it will make a whole lot of difference. So what I want to do in the next 10 minutes or so is to look at what you can do to enhance your self-exploration. So there are three exercises that are being done. Exercise means some kind of practice in which you can accelerate your self-exploration. So the first exercise is to look within, observe yourself by yourself. Okay. And this is a very important note, that this is one way to look at your insight, look at your imagination. Okay. This is one set of steps, not the set of steps. So this is one way to observe yourself. So if you are observing yourself, this is you. You are observing yourself. So you would be observing your imagination. So you'll be observing this. Also, you'll be observing over here, which is your natural acceptance. Okay. So you'll do some observation about yourself. Okay. And you'll be able to also see that whatever is happening outside in terms of your behavior and work first happened over here in your imagination. Then only it came out. That you must have seen even during the initial workshop. Now, when you have to look at your imagination or your natural acceptance, do you need to use your eyes or any part of your body to look at your imagination, what you're imagining now? Anybody? There are two hands raised. I'm sorry, I didn't see.
No need.
No need.
We are not using our eyes, or we are not using any of our body parts to look inside us.
Yeah. I'm turning on all the mics, whoever has raised their hand. So we'll, you know, we have just about 10 minutes remaining. So we'll try to complete this. Yeah, so we don't need to use our body for any of this. We don't have to so we can give rest to our eyes at least, and to the rest of the body also. You can give rest. You can be in any position. You can keep your eyes open, closed. Your body also, you can keep it in any posture, or you can stand or sit or dance or whatever it is. Okay, so to see your imagination, your body can be in any position. If you're observing yourself by yourself. Okay.
Yes, sir. Our assumption is enough, sir.
What is that, Nirmala ji?
Assumption. Assumption in the mind we can flow and we can imagine, not needed to concentrate on any part, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, so you have to, you can see your imagination without, you know, any mixing anything with it, without evaluating it, without reacting to it, without trying to stop it, and all that, you know. So without any of these, look into your own imagination. Okay. Dr. Kumara Dash, any observation or question? Dr. P. Ajita? Okay, so this is a very simple step to look into yourself. And the simplest way to look into yourself is to start looking into your imagination. So for today, we are just going to look into, see whether we are able to see our imagination or not. We can find out if it is going on sometimes or all the time. And from now till tomorrow, till we meet again, try to find out how much time you are aware of your imagination. So let's see if we are able to do that. So Dr. P. Ajita or Dr. Kumara Das.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Are you able to see your imagination?
Yes, sir.
You need your eyes to see, or you can see just like that?
Just if we think about that, we can see our imagination.
No. You're not imagining about your imagination. You can imagine your imagination. Force yourself to imagine something. That's not what we are talking about. We are saying that there is some imagination that is going on and you are observing it. This is happening at this time, then something else happens and all that. Right? So for example, you may be thinking about, oh, it is almost 5 o'clock, when will I go home? So you might be thinking about this. Then immediately after that, you might be thinking, oh, when I go home, I will have this, you know, I have this work to do. Then something else you might be thinking of. Something else you might be thinking of. Like that, you'll be thinking of many things.
Yes, sir.
Right? Yes. But if you are not doing this activity, you start imagining something that, see, this exercise has been given. So instead of observing what is really going on, I start forcing myself to think about something specific. Even then, some other thoughts will keep coming and going. So what I'm saying is that you observe these thoughts.
Normally, your concentration gets diverted at that time?
Yes. That if you're concentrating, I'm not asking you to concentrate. I am asking you to observe. Observe whatever is going on. So observe whatever is going on in your imagination without interfering with it. Very difficult to do, because we start, instead of observing, we start concentrating.
Yes.
Right? So if I say that you observe something, but don't think about, let us say, idli dosa, then you'll start concentrating on idli dosa only. So I'm asking you to observe, just observe, don't concentrate. Try to do this. Then you'll be able to see what is happening in your imagination.
In front of me, I feel like having that.
Yeah, that happens, no?
Yeah.
So you are concentrating. Don't do that. Just observe. You don't have to close your eyes, open your eyes, sit like this or like that or stand or anything. Be comfortable and simply observe. And you can observe when you are doing other things also. Right now, we have been for the last almost hour and a half, we have been in this session, right?
Yes,
so sometimes you would be thinking about, you know, your attention would be on what is going on in the session. So sometimes you might be thinking about what is going on in the session. But a whole lot of time you might be thinking about some other things. Then you come back to the session. Does that happen?
It normally won't happen. Sometimes it may happen, sir.
Okay, very nice.
If we focus on that and if we are very much focused on that, means we won't get diverted.
Right, right. So find out, you know, what. So this is, these are the three questions. Are you able to see your imagination? And if it is going on, if you are able to see your imagination, right, then find out if it is happening only sometimes or it is from time to time, not all the time.
Not all the time.
Okay. Is it not happening all the time or you are not able to observe it all the time? That also you can find out. All right.
Okay.
It may be going on all the time, but you are not aware of it. That might be the case. Or it might be the case that you are not imagining sometimes. But keep it open, find out. And how much of the time are you aware of your imagination? So you find out that. We'll ask you tomorrow in the first half hour from 9 to 9:30, I'll ask you these questions.
Okay.
And if we are able to develop ourselves, you know, this part, if we are able to do this, if we are able to develop ourselves, if we are able to do this, so this becomes, you know, very clear to us. We have the right understanding and we have no, you know, divergent from what is, if we are in that state, then we are able to live in harmony within and live in harmony with every other unit in existence. It's a very long way, but you know, step by step. So this is the first simple step to be aware and to start looking into your imagination. All right. And with that, we can be useful for our family. We can be helpful to our students, to our team as co-explorers. Okay. So if you have a family of few people, 5-6 people, 10 people, you can be helpful to them. They can be helpful to other people and so on. So we'll come to that as we go along. But you can be of help to others in their development. If your own development is taking place, isn't it? And as a resource person, you can be, or as a teacher, as a faculty member, you can be helpful to your students. Also, if you are at some, you know, level of understanding. So as a resource person, not only is conceptual clarity required, but also living with all of that. So if you're you have purified your sanskar and you are having the right understanding, right, and you are living like that, then it is a matter of being able to deliver or be of help to others. And in this case, as a faculty member to your students. So that's it from my side. There's a lot of homework to be done. What I would recommend is these three things. Write a summary. That is, draw the essence of whatever has been covered today. Okay. And you may like to discuss it with your family also. Take a note of their response also, if they will allow you to discuss with them. So write a summary of whatever has been covered today. It might take you some time to recall and then write down the summary. And then do this assignment number one. It has three sections. It should, if you are doing it, you know, with sincerity, it will take you some time, maybe an hour or so. And while you are doing all these things, be aware of your imagination. And if you can, at least make some note of what you saw in your imagination. So that's it from my side.